Distinguished speakers, the leaders of the foreign chambers of commerce, other distinguished guests and participants, friends, ladies and gentlemen, magandang araw po sa ating lahat. The Philippine agriculture sector had a poor growth performance from 2011 and 2019 compared to the industry and services sectors. However, during the COVID-19 pandemic, agriculture proved the most resilient among the three economic sectors. The country could have achieved a higher growth rate in agriculture if not for the African swine fever outbreak. In the first three quarters of 2021, the growth in the agriculture sector dropped by 1%. This may be due to a decline in livestock and corn production. The growth patterns of key commodities varied over time. For instance, the decline in livestock was due to African swine fever and lower demand. Growth rate in poultry has also a decreasing trend due to loss of institutional buyers, but is now slowly recovering. Rice has had an impressive growth rate, especially during this pandemic. This is important since it is a political commodity and its performance may be attributed to a rice policy reform enshrined in the rice tariffication law and the National Rice Production Program. For the Philippine agriculture sector to grow, there's a need to devise a strategy to promote growth in these commodities, particularly the triumvirate of livestock, poultry, and corn, the fisheries subsector, where aquaculture and mariculture have tremendous growth potentials given our huge coastal resources. Banana, pineapple, mango, avocado, and other fruit commodities where we have comparative advantage, and coconut, given that it is planted to 4 million hectares of land and has huge export potentials for its byproducts. The release of the Coconut Farmers and Industry Trust Fund Act, or Republic Act 11524, will help in attaining the goal of raising productivity and revenues of the coconut subsector. The 1DA reform agenda framework responds to the challenges of raising productivity and modernizing Philippine agriculture sector. It also hews closely with the ingredients of transforming agriculture as discussed in the very recent publication of the Asian Development Bank, Transforming Agriculture in Asia. The key agriculture transformation trends observed by the ADB study are as follows. Number one, shift of consumption preference to animal protein as income rises in the region. Number two, aging farmers, workers in the agriculture sector, and hence the imperative towards farm mechanization. Number three, crop diversification, particularly for agricultural exports, leading to a more developed agricultural economy. Number four, the challenges of climate change are increasingly being felt, and hence climate resilient measures have to be installed. And number five, shift from the provision of production support assistance like seeds, fertilizer, pesticides, and others to public goods like farm-to-market roads, irrigation, or service facilities, which last longer and benefit a larger public. The DA's flagship program, Plan, is currently the agency's response to the 5 transformation trends identified in the ADB study. The department continues to invite and encourage foreign chambers of commerce to further invest in the Philippine agricultural sector in areas such as smart agriculture, to include nutrient use, pest management, climate adaptation, greenhouse technologies, dairy, livestock, and poultry farming solutions, and biosecurity, aquaculture and mariculture farming technologies, and sustainable water technologies for irrigation. Major investment areas should also focus on tropical fruits like mango, avocado, pili, and pineapple, among others. Philippine agriculture has many potentials to encourage investments in the Philippines. We have a big growing middle-class market and a favorable policy environment, rich with investment incentives. The country also has a large pool of capable, young, and relatively skilled workers, abundant land and fisheries resources, and available local raw materials for agro-processing. Moreover, the Philippines has a strategic location with potential as an entry point to over 600 million people in the ASEAN market and to the RCEP markets once this regional cooperation is signed. Similarly, our country is a natural gateway to East Asian economies with a high global innovations ranking and friendly and hospitable people. Maraming salamat po. Mabuhay tayong lahat.